holding a Persian handshake with promise, written by Rakesh Sood. Now, this editorial is very important for political science optional students. It is important from general studies mains examination paper 2 point of view. It is also important from your essay and interview point of view. Now, in order to understand this editorial, I will not be explaining you what this handshake would result in. Rather, I will be explaining you what would have been the scenario had this handshake would not have taken place. What would have been the scenario? The scenario would have been like that, that Iran as a country would have become more fundamentalist. Iran as a country would have become more belligerent with respect to United States of America. Iran and United States of America's relationship would have become more antagonistic. There could have been more attrition between both the countries. Had this handshake would not have taken place, it could have resulted in forging up the alliance between ISIS and Iran. Had this handshake would not have taken place, Iran could have guided all the splinter terrorist organizations that are operating in the Middle East, in Africa, in West Asia, and it could have led them against the capitalist ideology. Had this handshake would not have taken place, it could have accorded more supreme role to Saudi Arabia in the Middle East. Had this handshake would not have taken place, the equation, the ongoing equation between Israel and Palestine would not have been solved. Had this handshake would not have taken place, the America would have ended up creating a big enemy. Had this handshake would not have taken place, it could have resulted in creating up a war in Europe between the moderate forces and the extremist forces. So for the moment, this handshake has resulted in engendering peace in the world. Now, what this handshake actually mean for Iran? When we look at it from the diplomacy point of view, this is a master stroke. This is a stroke of genius. This is a calculative move. This is a smart move. This is a smart strategy that has been played by United States of America. Now, United States of America has mastered this ideology. Ideology and technique of engaging the belligerent in the talks, coming out with some theoretical solution, then delaying that solution for a long period of time. This is something that we have also seen with respect to India and the United States of America. India was a kind of a pseudo-belligerent country to United States of America in the 80s and in the 90s. But in the 90s, it began to thaw up its relationship with India. And it was because of this thawness we have seen the India-US nuclear deal getting fructified. The deal, though, was done in 2005, but till date, we have not reaped any substantive, any real, any effective result out of that. The same thing is being replicated by United States of America in its relationship with Iran. It has been able to restrict, it has been able to put up a full stop on the nuclear program of Iran. It has been able to restrict the research, the development and the growth of nuclear technology in Iran. And that was its ultimate aim. Had Iran would have developed the nuclear technology viable for the nuclear weapons, it could have created a very big, huge and a phenomenal problem for United States of America. It has averted this problem by engaging with Iran, by putting up the things in written, but it will take a lot of time to implement the things that has been written on paper. Now, the thaw between United States of America and Iran in a shorter span of time could lead to the destabilization of the equation between United States of America, Iran and Israel. But in the longer term, the relationship between United States of America and Israel, they will not be following the path of withering. They will not be destabilizing, because it is the primary supporter. United States of America is the primary supporter of Israel on the issues of Palestine, on the issues of Lebanon, on the issues of Syria. So if it will not be supporting Israel on one of the issues, but it is its big supporter on a number of other issues. But we will see the alteration in the equation when we between United States of America and Saudi Arabia and Iran. Now, Saudi Arabia and Iran are the two contenders to lead the Muslim world, but they are divided in terms of one being a Shia and the other being a Sunni. Now, the thaw between United States of America and Iran could lead to the upping up of one community against the other. So this could lead to a destabilization of the relationship between United States of America and Saudi Arabia. This was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information about the classes that we are offering, you can visit our website. Name of the website is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. You can also join test series with us. That is the online test series. Now, in case you liked this video, please click on the like button and do share and comment on this video. Now, bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.